Hi, legendary student Hayden Smith here. Today we will be doing the four tenses of verbs for Latin 2.
Alright, so as Mr. Smith said, we are going to be covering the four tenses that you know up to this point in stage 21 of your Latin book. So those four tenses are the present, the imperfect, the perfect, and the pluperfect. So let's start with the present and the imperfect. And the reason these are grouped together is because they come from the same stem. So let's think of a Latin verb. That's a good idea. Let's use kello, kellare, kellavi, kellatus. All right, so the present and the imperfect tenses we use a stem based on the second principal part. All right, present, imperfect. To get to the stem, all you have to do is you chop off the re, and that's it, that's your stem, kella. So the present looks like this. Well, almost. This AO combination doesn't actually exist in Latin. What happens is it kind of gets molded together. So we end up with kello, like our first principal part. So, but there it is. There's our present endings. Imperfect. Take that same stem. Now we have to add a tense indicator. Right? When you translate the imperfect, you want to say someone was verbing, all right? Or had been was verbing, all right? And so what is the tense indicator of the imperfect? Yes, well, not be, be what? Be, yes, be a. All right, so we add that tense indicator on there. And then we just add our endings. This time, instead of an O, we add an M, but the rest stay the same. S, T, mus, tis, NT. So there we have it, our present and our imperfect tenses. Both come from that second principal part. Now let's move on to the perfect and the pluperfect. So with the perfect and the pluperfect, we're going to use a different principal part to get our stem. Which principal part is it? Yep, it's the third principal part. What are we going to chop off to get our stem? Good, it's the I. Excellent. So, for the perfect, we have kellavi, kellavisti, kellavit, kellavimus, kellavistis, kellaverunt. So our endings are a little different here. E isti it, imus itis erot. All right, but same idea. You're chopping off, you're finding the stem, you're adding on endings. Our pluperfect is going to use the same stem. Different set of endings, though. Can anyone remember what they are? Yes, that's it. They are eram, eras, erat, eramus, eratis, erat. So, all we have to do is add them on. So, kelaveram, kelaveras, kelaverat, kelaveramus, kelaveratis, kelaverat. And this holds true for most of all of our conjugations. Where you're using the second principal part for these two tenses, the third principal part for these two, you chop off the ending, and you add on a tense indicator sometimes with bom, bas, bat, bomus, batis, bant, or just a different set of endings. All right? But you notice that there's a pattern holds through for most of them. Most of them end have an O or an M, S for the second one, T for the third, M-U-S for first plural, T-I-S for second plural, and N-T for third plural. So that's how we kind of can memorize these patterns going on. All right, so hopefully that's a good enough review for you guys. Remember, if you have any other questions, you can always leave a comment down below, or you can feel free to email me. Thanks for watching.